Hi. In our first step, we're going to create template files. So template.configs to be used and be processed as templates that explain what our products do and how they exist. In this example, I'm just going to use two, and I'm going to create one for the GenWatt diesel 10 kilowatts engine and the GenWatt propane 100 kilowatt engine. I've already prepared these templates. They look like this. As you can see, normal Word files. Nothing special here, and they have a table with some overview of product items. So both are different, and now we want to just link them to our products in Salesforce. Cool. Step one, let's go to PDF Butler. And I'm gonna create two new doc configs. So I'm gonna create one for that's of type template Word document, so it's not a main Word document, which we would normally do, but now it's a template Word document, so it can be used, can be reused in various various main files. Okay, how I'm gonna call it? Let's call it this, like this, GenWatt diesel 10 kilowatts. Okay, don't mind about the title, and I'm not gonna save it for now. Okay, cool. Save and new. I'm going to create a second one as well for the GenWatt propane. It's again a template, of course. Next. Okay. And I'm not going to save it. So Base64 means not saving it. Just give me the technical representation so it can be used for, and it will be used for inputting it into the bigger document. So no title. Why? Because we're not going to generate this document standalone. We are always going to integrate it into a main Word document, so a main template that we are going to use. Okay, this is done. So next step is we now need to tell the system that these products are linked. These templates are linked to the certain products. How am I going to do that? I'm going to create a lookup on the product object to our doc config. Okay, let's do this. So it's a product here. Gonna create a new field. The field is going to be a lookup. And the lookup is going to go to doc config. Yeah, doc config like this one. So now we're going to link the via this lookup, we're going to link these products to our doc configs, of course, and for our templates. Okay, next. That's all fine. I'm just going to give it to everybody. And I want to, of course, add it to our product layout. That's perfect. So I do not want to see any of the relationships on the templates over there. Okay, let's save it. Okay, so this is now done. We have added the lookup. It's normally on the page layout. That should be done automatically, but let's double check. It's indeed here. It says our doc config. That's perfect. And now let's go to our products. I'm gonna go to products. We had the 10 kilowatts and the propane 100 kilowatts. I'm just opening them in new tabs, so just for easy editing and easy switching back and forward. So this is our .config field. It's there. Now I'm just going to edit here, and I'm going to search for a template, and this was the 10 kilowatts, so I'm going to select this template, the GenWatt diesel 10 kilowatts. Okay, and then the next one, again, let's do an edit here. And let's select the, this is the propane one for the 100 kilowatts. Okay, so this is done. Now we have linked our products. It's all it's all set together. Everything links together. So next up is actually creating putting these templates into our main document. That's our quote that we are generating to pass on information from these doc configs. One more time, I'm going to show the documents. So this is the kind of information we want to be adding to our quote that we are sending out to our customer. We are not done yet, of course. Now we have created the doc configs. We have created our templates. Next up is, of course, now adding these templates to our .configs. So we are going back to our .configs that we have just generated. And it were two normally. Yeah, it's these ones. So I'm just going to go to the 10 kilowatts, open PDF Butler. So I'm going to open up the configuration screen. Okay, and now I'm going to upload my document right here. So I'm going to select my document. It was the 10 kilowatts that I'm in now. And I'm going to give it an alternative name. So this is the English one. And I'm going to save to server. Okay, so now next up is the 100 kilowatts propane one. So open PDF Butler again. Okay, and I'm gonna upload here the documents for the 100 kilowatts. Also gonna call it in for the English one if you want to do multi-language or they have different templates. So also save to server. Now we are completely done. Our templates are uploaded to our .configs. Our .configs are linked to our products. So everything is set up. We are now good to go to the next step. So next up, we're gonna, of course, select the product sheets that we want to show on our quote. So we want to select the product sheets that are linked to the products that are at in our opportunity. If it's an opportunity or a quote, if it's CPQ or whatever, or any other type of relationship, it doesn't really matter. The principles always stays the same. We have a list of quote lines of products in this case, and in this list of products, we want to actually, for every product that has a template linked, we want to show that template. Now, we know, of course, that our 10 kilowatt has a template, so if I open that in a new tablet, it's just loading, I would know that it's linked to my product, and when I open this product, I know that this is linked to my doc config, and the system would need this doc config to actually take the correct or use the correct, show the correct template. So what's next? We're going to create a data source, new data source. It's going to be of type Sokol, of course, and I'm going to call it product sheets. It's going to be a list because it can, of course, have multiple multiple products linked to it. So let's save this one and of course use our famous Sokol builder to create this query. I'm gonna go for opportunity line item. The filtering takes a couple of seconds normally. This is out of our hands. It's what Salesforce offers. We have our opportunity, but we need the opportunity product. So that's the, if we go for the API names as the opportunity line item. So this opportunity product here. What I'm going to select from this one is the opportunity ID. Why do I need that? Because I need to filter on it to only select the products that are linked to my opportunity. So this I'm going to select. Then I'm going to select the product that's actually linked to it. So it's our product ID. I'm going to follow the relationship, and this relationship has normally a .config, as you can see. I'm going to follow that relationship as well, and here I'm going to select our customer .config ID. So this field I'm going to select, both will be the same, so we can select any of them. So let's use this one for now. I'm going to add this field. Then I'm going to add my filter here to filter it on opportunity ID equals the record ID. Add that filter to only select the products that I need from my opportunity. So now my query is created and I'm going to save my query. So now we have our product data source that will actually select all of the data sheets that we need, or the product sheets that we need. So next up is, of course, change our doc config. So let's move to our doc config. And this is our configuration. First step is let's add our newly created data source. It was a product sheets data source. So this is now added. And now I can use it. We're going to add in our document a new a new merge field, as we always do. And in this case, I'm just going to call it product sheets. So it knows that, so we know that the product sheets are going to come here. I just added a page break to make sure the product sheets start on the next page. Okay, so this is the document we will upload, and this is the merge field we will need. Let me copy it. And now create a config type. I'm going to call it product sheets. It's going to be of type document, and it's going to be at generation time. The render moment generation time means that in advance, you do not know which templates are going to be added dynamically. So we actually let the system create and add these templates at the moment we actually request our document. Our data source is going to be our product sheets. Our data source field is going to be our unique identifier. So the system must know which identifier to use, which ID to use, identifier to use for the, selecting the correct template. Merge field we already discussed, and I'm just going to go for single spacing. Okay, cool. Let's now save this, and I think this should be it. So let's go to our one of our opportunities. And let's generate our document from here. What I expect is that our document is generated and that it has all of the product sheets that we desire. Okay, let's take a look. This was it. This was the one I've selected. So I click the button and it's already generated. And I can see now it's my document, but also my templates are there just as I expected. So looking very good. Okay, this is it.